I had grown up knowing that a valve replacement was always something that was going to be part of my future, but I kind of anticipated maybe in my 40s or 50s, not being told at 25. So that was tough. And it was even harder for me because I had been accepted to medical school and I wanted to make sure that that wasn't affected by the surgery. I think being a patient has played a huge impact on how and who I am as a doctor. I think for me, it's a lot easier maybe to empathize with patients and spend a little bit more time when you recognize that someone's scared and getting a new diagnosis, because I was in their shoes not that long ago. My name is Kate Losenno. I'm 31. I'm a pediatric resident at the University of Toronto, and some of my hobbies are triathlons in the summer, and in the winter, I like snowboarding. I had my Ross procedure done June 20th of 2014 at Montreal Heart Institute by Dr. Ismail Alhamemzi. I was actually diagnosed very early on. They thought I had something called a bicuspid aortic valve, so I was watched by a cardiologist ever since I was a baby. My heart condition played a huge role in my ultimate career choice. I learned a little bit about it growing up and knew that I had this heart condition, so when I got to university, I wanted to know a lot more about it, and that's when I started doing some research in cardiovascular anatomy and physiology. I remember the first operation I saw was an aortic valve replacement, and from that day on I knew I absolutely had to go into medicine and specifically focus on cardiology or cardiac surgery. I'm kind of grateful that I got the diagnosis when I did, because it really forced me to take my health seriously and take it seriously in a way that made a positive and lasting change in my life. So in terms of my lifestyle, I went from someone who was pretty sedentary to running every day. And I started really small, just running 30 seconds and then walking 30 seconds. And gradually over months that went from running 30 seconds to running 5 kilometers to running 10 kilometers. And I actually did my very first triathlon less than a month before having my surgery. When I started running and making healthier food choices, along with that, I was actually able to lose about 100 pounds from the time I started medical school in September to the time I had surgery in June. In terms of other options that my cardiologist discussed with me, it was really the Ross procedure versus a mechanical valve versus a tissue valve. For me, the Ross was a no-brainer. I'm a young woman. I'm very active, so those two things immediately crossed off the mechanical valve for me, because I did not want to be on warfarin for my entire life and have that increased risk of bleeding. And I think the other thing to really consider in young women is that if they want to go on and get pregnant down the road, warfarin is a contraindication to that. So right away, mechanical valve was a non-starter. The issue for me with the tissue valve is the longevity. So being a young, active person, the chances of me getting even 10 or 15 years out of the tissue valve, I didn't feel were good enough. And so what that would mean for me is a reoperation every 10 years to replace, you know, a degenerating valve, and what kind of quality of life would that be? Talking with Dr. Alhamemzi about the Ross procedure made me feel very comfortable about my decision. He explained a little bit more to me about having the living tissue on the left side, so in your aortic valve, and how important that was. And for me, one of the biggest things was kind of the long term. He talked about the data, explained that there are very good long-term outcomes for both the pulmonary and the aortic valve. After my surgery and after getting back to kind of my regular running routine, I noticed a huge difference in my exercise capacity and my symptoms. Exactly 1 year after my operation, I did my first triathlon in Canada, the Toronto Triathlon Festival, and I did that as a celebration of 1 year post-op. I was able to train just like anyone else was. I was competing against athletes of all ages, and it was really special to me. My advice to cardiologists would be to, of course, discuss the standard options of the tissue and mechanical valve, but to offer patients the option of a Ross procedure. Even if maybe the cardiologist isn't as comfortable with it, I think it's important that patients know about it so that they can ask a surgeon or do the research that they need to do. the Ross procedure is not for everyone, and the Ross procedure is not really for every surgeon. So I think it's really important that patients are able to find surgeons who specialize in this repair and get the information from those surgeons, because they're the ones who are doing the surgeries and are really up to date on the material and the evidence, and will provide the patient with the best, most accurate data so that they can make the right decision. The final decision really was my only decision. I didn't feel comfortable with either a tissue or mechanical valve, so for me it was really the Ross procedure all the way. I'm very happy that I had the Ross. If I had to, I would make that decision every day.